Hey, what's up, guys? Chris here from the Blu-ray Critic. Thought I'd do a video about the Oscars and talk a little bit about the winners and, you know, just give you my opinion. But I'm quite thrilled. Guillermo del Toro wins Best Director for The Shape of Water, and it just couldn't have happened to a better person. Really humble guy. One of the nicest people in the business, definitely. And he also won Best Picture for The Shape of Water. Although Get Out was well-directed, too, with Jordan Peele. Also, Best Actress in a Leading Role went to Frances McDormand for 3 Billboards. And congratulations to her on that. This is, I believe, her second win. And always been a fan of her since Fargo. And some people were saying that Sally Hawkins might pull off the win for The Shape of Water. But, yeah, and I really liked what Frances did on stage, you know. She asked some of her colleagues to stand up, so that was a really nice moment. Best actor in a leading role went to Gary Oldman for The Darkest Hour, another wonderful actor. And I'm actually quite surprised that he hasn't won an Oscar before, because he's been in so many great films with wonderful performances. One comes to mind, of course, is Bram Stoker's Dracula, and he played the villain in Air Force One. But yeah, just one of the most down-to-earth people in the business. Best actor in a supporting role went to Sam Rockwell, also for 3 Billboards, and congratulations to Sam. Although I was kind of hoping for Christopher Plummer to pull off the win for All the Money in the World, because I really loved his performance in that film. And considering the fact that he had to deliver that type of performance in the last second when he had to step in for Kevin Spacey because of all the allegations, you know, that came about towards him. Best actress in a supporting role went to Allison Janney for I, Tonya. And from the get-go, they were already mentioning that she's going to win. So I'm not that surprised of her, you know, winning Best Actress for the supporting role category. Best Writing went to James Ivory for Call Me By Your Name. Also, Best Writing Original Screenplay went to Jordan Peele. Congratulations, well-deserved, for Get Out. Best Foreign Language Film went to a movie called A Fantastic Woman. I have yet to see that one. Also, Best Animated Feature Film went to Coco. Congratulations to Disney on that wonderful movie. Love that one a lot. And of all people, Kobe Bryant wins an Oscar. Can you believe that? For his animated short film, Dear Basketball. Can't believe I'm even saying that. But it was actually a pretty decent short film. So if you haven't seen it, do check it out. And it's composed by the legend himself, John Williams. And Best Cinematography goes to another legend, Roger Deakins, for Blade Runner 2049. So well-deserved on that. So anyway, these are some of the main winners of the evening. Of course, there's a lot more, which I'm not going to get into. But I thought Jimmy Kimmel did a great job hosting the show. He was funny. He hit the mark. There were some cringeworthy moments or awkward moments, like launching hot dogs into the theater audience, which was, you know, not my cup of tea, but it was fun for a lot of people, I'm sure. You know, especially you're watching a movie and, you know, inside a theater, and then in comes Mark Hamill, Gal Gadot, and the rest of the gang that Jimmy Kimmel brought in. And it was really cool to see also a couple legendary actor and actress come in to announce, you know, the Best Picture winner once again, and that is Warren Beatty and Faye Dunaway. And at least this time around, they didn't screw things up. But honestly, it wasn't even their fault. They were just given the wrong envelope last year when they read La La Land instead of Moonlight. So anyway, that's just my rant. Wanted to give you guys a rundown as far as some of the main winners of the evening for the Oscars. So anyway, thanks for hearing me rant, and I'll see you guys soon in my next update. Take care.